هذا السؤال من آخر اسمه عبادة، يقول: ما تقولون في شدة الهيبة والحياء من الشيخ لدرجة عدم القدرة على مخاطبته؟ هل تعتبر من القواطع التي يجب تجاوزها أم هي من نعم الله؟
He said, this is from Ibadah, and he said, what do you say about an intense awe of of one's sheikh and a shyness to the extent that the person is not able to speak to him? He said, is this considered one of the things that will cut someone off, or is this a blessing?
ينبغي أن يكون على بصيرة فيها وإن كان أصلها خير.
He said that the person should observe this or be in a state of insight, which can also mean upon proper knowledge, even if in and of itself is from a good place.
والبصيرة أن لا يمنعه هيبته للشيخ ولا حياؤه منه ولا تعظيمه له عن الاستفادة منه في عرض حاله عليه.
And this insight is that the person's awe and magnificence, magnification of their sheikh and shyness from them should not prevent them from presenting their case and explaining to them what is happening to them.
ولا يمنعه عن سؤاله إياه فيما يحتاج إليه في أمر دينه وسيره إلى الله.
And it should not prevent the person from asking the sheikh that which they need in the affair of their religion and their traveling to Allah.
ولا يمنعه عن استبيان المراد من كلام الشيخ فيما يشكل عليه من أمره.
And it should also not prevent the person from trying to seek clarification of the intention or the meaning that is intended by something that the sheikh says to him.
فإذا كان على هذه البصيرة لم تكن من القواطع وكانت سببا لارتقاء درجته.
And if it is on, if it is in this or with this insight, it is not something that would cut off the person's journey, and it would be a cause of raising of their station.
ولنعلم أن خير الأحوال هدي سادتنا الصحابة مع سيد الوجود صلى الله عليه وسلم.
And we should know that the best guidance or the best way is that of our masters, the companions, with Allah's Messenger صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم.
فليس في تاريخ البشر من أحب أحدا كما أحب أصحاب محمد محمدا.
And there's no one in human history who loved anyone like the companions of Muhammad loved Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ولا من عظم أحدا كما عظم أصحاب محمد محمدا.
Nor anyone who magnified or held anyone in esteem like the companions of Muhammad did Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم.
ذلك كانوا يعرضون أحوالهم عليه ويستشيرون يرونه في أمورهم ويستفهمونه عما أشكل عليهم.
And with this, they would present their circumstances to him and seek his counsel in their affairs and ask him about those things which they didn't understand.
هذه تقول اسمها عائشة لما يذكر اسم البلد. تقول أمي انتهت من ذكر سبحانك إن كنت من الظالمين 40,000 مرة تذكر ذكر يعطيتها فاتوك أنه يحتوي سبحانك حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل تقرأوه 45,000 فلتقرأه 45,000.
So this question is from Aisha, and again the location is not mentioned, and it's preferred that the location be mentioned. And she said that her mother finished saying a dhikr subhanaka تقصد لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك لا إله إلا أنت سبحانك إني كنت من الظالمين 40 times. And and also she doesn't remember a dhikr that was prescribed thereafter. And he said حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل, and she says that كم مرة
45,000
أيوة 45,000 times حسبي الله ونعم الوكيل
حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل
حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل 45,000 times.
ويسأل هذا عن جلب البركة إلى الأوقات.
And someone asked about bringing barakah into their times.
أن تغمرها بذكر الله تبارك وتعالى والفرح برحمته.
He said that the times be filled or made to thrive with dhikr of Allah تبارك وتعالى and feeling joy at His mercy.
وذكر رسوله صلى الله عليه وسلم والشوق إلى لقائه.
And mentioning the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and longing to meet him.
فإن هذا يورث انشراحا في الصدر يحسن به ترتيب الوقت وتحصل بركة الوقت.
This produces an expansion of the breast through which a person organizes their time well, and also there it brings blessing to their time.
فعلى طالب البركة في وقته أن يعين للأعمال التي يقوم بها أوقاتا ويختار منها ما هو أولى لا يقدم عليه غيره.
He said someone who's seeking a blessing in their time, they should organize or appoint, designate a specific time for certain works, and in that time they should do that which is most appropriate and not give anything else precedence.
فيأخذ نصيبه من تنظيم الوقت مع الحال الذي ذكرناه.
So then this person should have some amount of organizing their times along with the state that's just been mentioned.
ثم إذا ارتبط بعمل أو سعي فليداوم عليه وليواظب فإن البركة تظهر مع المداومة.
And he said then if this is connected to deeds and a striving or an effort, they persist in this because the barakah occurs through persistence or after persistence.
وهذا يسأل قال أعاني من الكآبة النفسية فنذهب إلى الطبيب هل هناك دواء لمعالجة ذلك؟
He said, and this is I believe from Natalie, the person has a state of depression and should, and they're in a state of fear because this or no, they fear going to a doctor about this, and is there a dua for which is a remedy for this?
فليأخذ ما ذكرنا من دعاء الكربي ومن دعاء الحق باسمه اللطيف.
And he said that they should say that what was mentioned of دعاء الكرب, and that was the du'as that were mentioned for difficulty. It was La ilaha illallah al-azim al-halim to the end of the du'a that he mentioned for the first questioner, and also the dhikr that was mentioned Ya Latif, and he mentioned that in the response to the same questioner. So those two du'as that were mentioned in the response to the previous questioner, this person should say those as well.
ويفيده في هذا قراءة سورة لم نشرح بعد كل صلاة.
And also reading Surah Alam Nashrah after each prayer is of benefit as well.
وَكَذَلِكَ أَنْ يَقْرَأَ فِي كُلِّ يَوْمٍ مِئَةَ مَرَّةٍ رَبِّ اشْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي.
And also for a person to read every day 100 times this dua that he's mentioned.